So we saw a lot of confusion in the forums about what was going on with this gradient descent. The equations that were given to you were sort of presented as a black box, and I'd like to open up that black box and see what's going on inside. So for those of you who looked at Wikipedia to try to understand what's going on with gradient descent, the first formula you would have encountered was this one. And this equation describes gradient descent. Now, this is a little intimidating at first. What do all of these parameters mean? B equals A minus gamma times the gradient of the function evaluated A. Let's figure out what's going on here. So before we get into gradient descent, let's first answer the question, what is a gradient? And to help me answer this question, I'm going to get the help of my blindfolded hill climber. So here's our blindfolded hill climber, and he's climbing this rounded hill. He wants to get to the top, and he wants to do it in as few steps as possible. What is his method going to be? Well, as long as the hill is steep, he knows he can afford to take a really big step because he's still not really close to the top. As the hill smooths out and becomes more level, he's going to want to take smaller and smaller steps because he's going to be afraid of overshooting the top and winding up on the other side of the hill. So how can we describe this mathematically? And the way we're going to do that is by using the gradient. And when we do that, our climber is going to get to the top of the hill. So let's look at this hill from a top-down view instead of from the side. And I'm going to draw these isoclines. So these lines all represent lines of the same altitude. And we can see they come together. They're really close together in the beginning and become further and further apart as we go inside. And that's because the hill is getting less and less steep. So at any point, the gradient is a vector. If I took the gradient at, let's say, this point, I would get a vector pointing in the direction of steepest descent. And the length of that vector would depend on exactly how steep the hill is. So at this point, which maybe corresponds to somewhere down here on the hill is quite steep, so our vector is quite long, and it points directly uphill. If I was over here and taking the gradient, I would still be pointing uphill, but the vector wouldn't be quite as long now, because now we're up here, and the slope isn't so great. And with a reduced slope comes a reduced gradient and a reduced step size for a blindfolded hill climber. Gradient descent is very similar to blindfolded hill climbing. Now, instead of climbing up a hill, we're climbing into a valley and trying to find the bottom of it because we want to minimize a function. That minimization is encoded in this minus sign, so instead of adding the gradient, we're going to subtract it. And let's talk about what each of these variables mean. So A is our current position. If we were the hill climber, it would be right here where he starts off. B is going to be his next position. So this is how the hill climber decides where to go next. This gradient term tells us the direction of steepest ascent, and this minus sign flips that around and says, okay, let's actually find the direction of steepest descent, and this gamma is just a weighting factor. So that's all this formula is doing. It's saying, let's take a step down the hill and use that as our new equation, our new position, sorry. And now, to elaborate on this, we're going to need to use a little bit of calculus. So if you don't know calculus, don't be intimidated. Try your best to follow along. And if you can't, that's okay too. I think this kind of captures the essence of what's going on with gradient descent. So first we have to figure out what exactly is the function we're trying to minimize. For the purposes of the lecture, the function we were trying to minimize was a function of yi, and it was equal to some weighting alpha times xi minus yi squared plus some weighting beta times yi minus yi plus 1 squared, so the next y-coordinate, and we also do the same for the previous y-coordinate, so yi minus 1. So we want to minimize this, and we're going to use gradient descent. Well, gradient descent says that we should just iterate over this process until we get to a sufficiently shallow slope that we're confident we're in the bottom. We've really found a minimum. So at each step, we're going to follow this. B, our new location, becomes yi prime. That's going to equal our old location, yi, and then minus this gradient. And the gradient here, it's just going to be the derivative with respect to yi. If you don't know calculus, again, don't worry about it. And if you do, this is a fairly simple derivative. So I'm going to write it simplified. I'm not going to show you all the intermediate steps. But once we do this out, we find that yi prime equals yi plus 2 alpha times xi minus yi plus 2 beta times yi plus 1 plus yi minus 1 minus 2yi. And this almost almost looks like the equation that you were given in class. There's a little problem, and that's these twos. And I'm going to do something where I just erase them. And you may be saying, hey, you're not allowed to do that. But let's just pretend I had originally called these parameters alpha over 2 and beta over 2, and then everything will work out just fine. So that's gradient descent. That's where this equation comes from in our update step. This would be simultaneous update, another good way of using gradient descent. It's not how we implemented it in the lectures, but that's okay. And I hope this was helpful. Good luck.